Let's take a look at renaming records and transactions in NetSuite. Did you know that you can rename records and transactions to match your company's terminology where it differs from NetSuite's terminology? To access the renaming records and transactions page, log in as the administrator and navigate to Setup, Company, and under Setup Tasks, Rename Records and Transactions. On this page, you can change the names of three entities: relationship records, transactions, and account types. First, at the top of this page, you can edit the names of relationship records. You can see all of NetSuite's standard names in the field names. NetSuite has also already populated the fields under each record name with the standard name, but you can easily update the name of a record by changing the field. For example, perhaps in your company you use the term client instead of customer, or you may use job instead of project. Simply write the new term in the field and save your change. You can update the names of transactions under the Transaction Name subtab. NetSuite provides their original name under the Type column. To change the name, simply alter the Name column. You can also change the abbreviation of transactions to correspond with your new transaction name. Note that this functionality is unique to transactions. Neither the records nor the account types have abbreviations that you can alter. And finally, you can change account names under the account type names. As with transactions above, you can see the original NetSuite name under the type column, and you can change the name under the name column. One unique characteristic in this section is that you can adjust the order of the names. To do this, simply select the account you wish to move and use the Move to Top and Move to Bottom buttons to relocate the account on the list. Note that the order of accounts in this list does not affect the order that these accounts appear anywhere else in NetSuite. Renaming records and transactions is fairly simple, but some areas may cause confusion. First, remember to change any customized items that have the original name. When you change the name of a record, transaction, or account item, that name generally updates throughout NetSuite. However, it will not update for any customized items. For example, if you have a custom field, a custom form, or a custom tab that uses the previous name, you will need to manually change the name to reflect your company's preference. Another potential problem is that when the administrator renames records or transactions, the new name applies only for the preferred language currently set under set preferences. In other words, if an administrator who has English set as the preferred language makes a name change for a record, that change would not appear for a user with French set as their preferred language. In order to update a record or transaction name for every language used by your company, you will need to set each language as your preferred language in turn and update the record or transaction name for that language. Another caution in renaming records and transactions is that you must be careful to avoid having duplicate names. Surprisingly, NetSuite will accept duplicate names, but you can imagine the confusion that this situation could create. A final potential problem would be looking up a renamed record or transaction in the Help Center. You may be concerned that you will not get the result you need since NetSuite does not natively recognize that name. But NetSuite's got you covered here. Go ahead and search for your custom name. NetSuite will notice that you are searching for a custom name and will ask if you intended to search for the original name. All you have to do is click the link provided in the Help Center to access all the results for that record or transaction under its native NetSuite name. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.